The man who helped cover up the Snowtown killings, including the murder of his own wife, could be back on the streets of Adelaide within days.
After 25 years behind bars, Mark Haydon's been granted parole, which will likely include unsupervised day trips in the community.
Fresh air and more room than he's had in 25 years. These cottages at Northfield are about to become home to Mark Haydon, a final step towards complete freedom.
The pre-release centre is a stepping stone into the community. It's low security.
The 65-year-old was today granted early release, the parole board saying he's been a model prisoner. He's sorry for his crimes and has had no incidents of drug use or violence. Cold comfort for the Snowtown victims' families.
He's just basically living in fear again. I'm even shaken.
A man once described as a monster, Haydon helped the Snowtown killers dispose of the bodies of seven of their 11 victims, including his own wife. His imminent release will bring new freedoms, family visits, employment and volunteering, as long as he wears an electronic bracelet and returns to the centre by 9 p.m. each night.
We're looking at the man now, not the man that was 25 years ago.
But on May 20, he'll be released into the community with no restrictions, unless new laws that could see him supervised upon release come into force in time.
You're breaching conditions of parole, you can have the potential to be back in jail, and yes, if you breach conditions of an extended supervision order, there is the potential for you to go back to jail.
Haydon yesterday gave the parole board a disturbing insight into why he helped cover up these horrific crimes. He says he was terrified he would become the Snowtown killer's next target if he didn't help bury the victims' bodies.
He had a shocking childhood. He was subjected to violence at a very early age. He was very much influenced by Bunting.
And today, shocking new details about the killers themselves. The parole board chairwoman revealing Robert Wagner has shown no remorse behind bars, while John Bunting is proud to be a serial killer.
24/7, 366 days a year, we come home and there's an empty seat at the table.
Hannah Ford, 7 News.